Hi, my name is Cassie Hodes, and today for my digital memoir, I'm going to be telling you guys a story about a time that I took some of my younger siblings to Opry Mills and how that shaped my racial view of the world, I guess. So I grew up around a big family, and two of my younger brothers are of different ethnic backgrounds. One of them is black and one of them is biracial. And so I was older when they came around because one is almost seven and the other one's six. So when they were adopted, we were older. And so the older ones kind of just took them under our wing and they're our little babies. And so right before Christmas, 2 years ago, I took them to Opry Mills to go to Build-A-Bear and pick up some shoes that Santa was going to get for them. And I'd taken the kids into the Radio Shack at Opry Mills, and I had two of my younger sisters with me as well. And one of them had gone to Claire's to get something for her ears. And the other one was still with me, and we were shopping, and I was like, no, you can't get that, quit touching stuff. And they were just kind of playing around while I went and got a phone charger. And this woman has the audacity to walk up to me and goes, oh, I'm so proud of you for raising someone else's kids. It really takes a strong woman to do that. I looked at this woman like she just shot my cat, like, oh my goodness. I can't believe she thought that she could say that. She was a complete stranger, and so I had Faith take the boys out in the little vestibule area of the mall, and I asked this woman why she thought she could say something like that to an 18-year-old girl who had two kids and someone who was about 8 years old with her. Why she thought that that was her place to interject into her, like, her beliefs on how racial profiling and, like, what she thought races should be. And I was like, those are my little brothers. I love them to death. I will love them forever, no matter what color their skin is. And I think it's very rude that you would come up to me, even though you were trying to give me a compliment. That was the worst backhanded compliment I had ever received. And I was like, doesn't matter what color they are, they're still family and I still love them. And so I've prepared like a little 6-picture slideshow of some recent pictures and then one that's a couple years old back when Josiah was still on oxygen. And it just, that got to me and that shaped my racial beliefs, I guess, that people didn't have the same like open beliefs that I did. But anyways, so here's that slideshow for you.
This is the end. Hold your breath and count.